flag is out, and we are racing. Ladies and gentlemen, we are here and live at the sister track of Daytona International Speedway for the running of our fifth race of the season, the Aaron's 499, right here at Talladega Super Speedway. This place has created so much history over the years, from NR competition to real-life competition, especially WRLA competition, where Alex Bonsignor, after having heartbreak after heartbreak, especially after losing the Canadian 500 to another former driver, Alex Hawkins, and then coming here a few months later, winning here at Talladega. He almost came close to winning the 2020 edition before that was taken by Daniel Voiles, who at the time was our in-race reporter, one of two of in-race reporters that year. But it's 2023. We are definitely guaranteed to have ourselves a new winner, and this definitely should be pretty wild and chaotic and very interesting to see. Just in case if you weren't with us last week, we were at the Rockingham Speedway, and it was mostly a caution-free event that saw quite a few lead changes left and right, but towards the end of the event, it came down to Haley Couris in the 13 and Emmanuel Hartnett in the number 20, and the veterans and the veteranship prevail. I don't even know what I was saying there, but you get what I mean. But the veteran experience prevailed in the side of Emmanuel Hartnett, and he went on to take the checkered flag for his first win of the season and his third overall WRLA Pepsi Cup Series win. Currently the all-time winningest driver in WRLA as we speak. So while we have an opportunity before we talk about what to expect in this race, why don't we go ahead and take a look at our point standings coming into today's events, coming into our fifth race of the season. Of course, Emmanuel Hartnett, after his win at Rockingham, he takes the points lead with 153 points in his pocket. Zachary Taylor, who is our Michigan winner, falls back to second, unfortunately losing the points lead. He has 127 points in the bank. Allison Rain continuing a very strong and consistent season. She has 124. Two behind her is Andrew Miller, also having himself a great run this year. Tanner Parton, who had a dominating win at Mosport, has 112 points in the bank, alongside Susie Atikin, who is tied with Tanner Parton, but the tiebreaker is the win that Parton has over Susie Atikin. So Atikin right now is sixth. Then seventh, Joshua Hyatt, also tied. I guess it's a three-way tie for the fifth position in the point standings, but obviously Parton breaks that tie, as I mentioned before. But Joshua Hyatt, seventh with 112 in the bank. Nathan Stapleton in the 97 with 108 points to his credit. Colin Cropley, ninth, with Jack Lagasse rounding out the top 10, both with 102 points in their respective pockets. But Colin Cropley breaks the tie due to Google Sheets physics. But one thing that we're definitely going to have to expect here in this race, obviously, with the super speedway type of racing, this is a little bit of an older package, so we are still going to see some 2 and 3 wide, but I would expect some drivers to get a little bit spread out. The pack will kind of be a little bit spread out. That's what I meant to say. But I would say that this race is definitely still going to be pretty interesting to watch, but you definitely don't want to get up in that extreme outside line right up against the wall, because once you do, you just start falling forward, farther and farther to the back of the field, and you might have to start your whole work over from scratch, especially when it just comes down to getting towards the front of the field. Well, I've pretty much said all I needed to say. We've gone over the points. We've talked about what to expect. So we're just going to leave all the action to all the drivers. So definitely going to be a very fun one to watch, and we're glad that you're here with us here at Talladega Super Speedway. 1/6 of the way through, and we're almost a third. The drivers are strapped into their cars. Pre-race ceremonies are just now starting to wrap up, But in order to get these 42 behemoths rolling on the racetrack, we got to get the command to fire the engines.
Drivers, start your engines!
Engines have fired. Pace car is rolling off, and so are these 42 competitors. And as they head out onto the racetrack, starting lineup will be rolling at the very bottom of your screen. You can see right there, Josiah Munsell drew the pole position after making it into today's event. And lining up alongside was one of the most winningest drivers in the 2020 Pepsi Cup Series season. That would be Al Lagassi. This was back at the time when he was a rookie, and this was around the time when we were using the Gen 6 race cars. But nonetheless, we're going to be having ourselves a pretty interesting time here at the Talladega Super Speedway. This is our first Super Speedway race of the season. First of two will be at Daytona later on in the year, right around, I believe, 4th of July weekend. Or maybe late June, possibly. It depends on either or. But 38 laps and 42 drivers at the ready here at the Talladega Super Speedway. The type of plate racing that we might see. Well, of course, we're going to see a little bit of three wide, as we had probably mentioned a little bit ago. But I would expect with this different type of Super Speedway package, especially on these types of race cars, they're going to be a little bit more strung out. So it's going to be a little bit more difficult for those that really want to see a big one happen, for that to really happen. So we might see some really good racing, but perhaps another caution-free event. We have had two thus far this year. Two races in a row back at Mosport, and then last week at Rockingham, surprisingly at Rockingham, that everybody managed to take care of their stuff and keep it clean and green all the way to the end. But will we see that here at Talladega? Let's find out if it's going to be three races in a row that will be caution-free. Pace car is in, and this will put the field into the hands of Josiah Munsell and Al Lagassi to lead the field of the green flag to get race number 5 underway from here at the Talladega Super Speedway. There's the green flag, and we're underway. Lagassi drops low as they go down the back straightaway, heading towards turn number 3. You see Elijah Gordon at 77. Going to make it 3 wide inside of the top 10. Now this is a run that Gordon is definitely going to need here, even though it is still very early in this race. It's great to see him up here towards the front of the field, dead last in the point standings coming into today's event. He certainly would love to change all that here at the Talladega Super Speedway. Lagassi leads lap number 1. Munsell gets kicked back to 5th, and now they're 3 wide up towards the front of the field, 3 rows deep. Munsell, our pole sitter, is stuck on that third line. Baranauskas jumps high and then goes to the middle. Going to stay tucked in behind the number 34 of Lagassi as they head back into turn number 3. Now they're 3 wide, 4, maybe 5 rows deep. Gordon now leading the middle. Emily Anderson there in that 66 down low. There's Michael DeFeo on that number 6 making his first start of the season. Now being trapped in a 4 wide situation with himself, Anderson in the middle, Gordon up top, Wyatt Walker on the bottom as we got a battle for the lead up front. Lagassi and Baranauskas have pulled out just far enough to where it's basically them, those two, that can just battle it out for the lead. Lagassi is going to let Baranauskas have it. No contest as they go back down the back straightaway once again with 2.5 laps complete. See Wyatt Walker there in that 19, diving low with a little bit of help from his Pontiac teammate of Tanner Parton, who won it, Canadian Tire Motorsports Park, in very dominating fashion. There's really no contest for position, at least for the first 5 laps of that event. And then after that, it just got single file, and nobody was really able to pass unless somebody made a mistake. But here at Dega, there's going to be plenty of passing, especially if it's for that lead. So far, we've only had 2 lead changes, from Munsell to Lagacy, then to, currently, Audra Baranauskas. Michael DeFeo looking to try to become the 4th different leader here in this event. He goes down to the inside with a little bit of help from Emily Anderson, and you see in the background, that is Bob Floyd, who got shuffled out of line in that number 11, and he fell all the way back from 8th, now just outside of the top 10. He might fall outside of the top 20 here. Let's see. Let's just actually keep track of where Bob Floyd just ended up at. He went from 8th all the way back to 25th. He lost 17 positions in just one lap. 17 spots. I cannot even fathom that. As you see, DeFeo has just went to the lead. And Baranauskas is going to want it back. She goes down low. And Tanner Parton, Braden Perez, there's Nathan Stapleton in the 97, who started closer to the back of the field, has now moved up inside of the top 5 and is going to try to follow close behind the number 79 of Parton as he takes the lead. Well, let's see at the line. He takes it just barely by 1/100th of a second over Audra Baranauskas. And you see right here, we're starting to get a little bit more strung out. There's Travis Crampton in the number 61. Now Crampton, this is another time that Crampton is going to need another good run. So far, I mean, he hasn't gotten off on the right foot this year. You see him going for the lead underneath of Ray Atikian as well as Tanner Parton. And Crampton clears everybody for the top position as they come off of turn number 4. Let's see if he can lead this lap. Man, this is going to be pretty big if he can lead this one. That'll be a bonus point towards the championship for him. He'll easily lead it over Wayne Lopez, who sits in that second spot. DeFeo hanging around inside of the top 5, doing a very nice job. But coming into this event, Travis Crampton is third, I believe, if I'm correct here. No, these are the wrong points, actually, that I'm looking at. Yeah, I don't think I have the correct points. But that's not okay. I don't believe I have the correct point standings, actually. No, wait, no, I do. I lied. Crampton comes into this race 32nd in the point standings with 58 points in the tank. And right now he's running inside of the top 5. He just lost the lead to Wayne Lopez. And now getting shuffled up on the top side, he is going to start dropping back like a rock. But Crampton right now is 32nd in points. And he is definitely going to need some good runs here. He almost had a good run at Rockingham last week. He was running inside of the top 10, having himself a good run, good race. And then just, unfortunately, fuel mileage kind of, well, really fuel strategy kind of just altered that good run. And he wasn't able to capitalize on it. But everybody over here in this part of the pack is now bunched right back up. They are 3 wide, almost 4 wide. They are 4 wide. Joshua Hyatt, Allison Rain trapped in the middle with CG Hall on the bottom, Crampton up top. They settle it back down to 3 wide for about 3 seconds. Crampton is still stuck on that extreme top side as you see up front. Number 51, Ryan Gundolo, has gone to the lead, and they're going to be 3 wide for the top spot as they head back into turn number 3. Nathan Stapleton, as quickly as Ryan Gundolo took the lead, he's going to lose it to Nathan Stapleton in the 97. A couple Chevrolet, 3 Chevrolet teammates lined up behind him. Baranauskas and now Perez fighting it out for second. Bonsignor, who won here back in 2017, is looking on. He came close to winning this event back in 2020. Could have gone theoretically back to back, but lost it to Daniel Voiles back in 2020, back when he was racing in the Pepsi Cup Series at the time. Baranauskas dives low. She wants to lead back. As they head back into turn number three, coming around to complete lap number 10. You have Emmanuel Hartnett, who won at Rockingham last week in a very, very entertaining battle between himself and Haley Couris, who was en route for her first career win. But the veteran experience paid off on the part of Emmanuel Hartnett, and Hartnett barely holding onto the points lead coming into today's race. He wants to increase his points lead as he's running inside of the top five and pushing Nathan Stapleton by the number two of Audra Baranauskas. Baranauskas with no help, but she is barely hanging on down on that inside line. But not for much longer. You see Stapleton drop down in front of Audra Baranauskas as they head back into turn number three. And now Hartnett has absolutely no help whatsoever. He's going to get trapped up high. They race off of turn number four once again. Mitchell Collins, who has now pulled himself up inside of the top five. There he is, now getting put up around the outside by the number three of Joshua Hyatt, being put up in that second lane. And now back down into turn number one once again. Three wide, Stephen Cologne trapped in the middle. Emmanuel Hartnett is going to drop back in behind the number 25. Now down to the inside, he has found a hole. On the bottom, goes back up top. Bradley Bradshaw on that 47 crossed over on that number 20 of Hartnett. And they're three wide for the lead once again. This time Stapleton losing that battle very, very easily. C.G. Hall lost it just as badly as Stapleton. But Joshua Hyatt for Full Frontal Motorsports to the point, bringing his teammate Audra Baranauskas with him. But don't look now, Wayne Lopez down on the inside as they head back into turn number one, and you see the ticker, 1-2-3, 3-2-1. That's a one in a million thing that you see here on NR 2003. One in a million, man. See Baranauskas now getting a little bit of assistance from the 69 of Ray Atikian. Back down into turn number three. Baranauskas is going to take the top position away from Joshua Hyatt as they come off of turn number four. And there's the number 13 of Haley Couris, whom I mentioned earlier, was en route for her first Pepsi Cup Series win, but was taken away by Emmanuel Hartnett, and all mostly thanks to lap traffic. That kind of cost her the win, but she still managed to get a really good result nonetheless, even though she's racing with nothing to lose. She's racing part-time to get into every single event. But really, for a driver with nothing to lose, she definitely could have had a lot to gain. If she were competing for the championship, that is. Zachary Taylor was up here just a lap ago, and you see him in that number 85. He is drifting back. As quickly as he came up through the field, he was in the seventh position at the time. Wait a minute, the caution, I believe, is out? Yes, it is. Caution is out. We had a crash in turn number three. And leading them back to the flag was the number 69 of Ray Atikian. And we are not going to have three races in a row where we have been caution free. I can't believe we missed that. The zero of Quinton Moore. A little buckle on the hood. Maybe some damage a little here and there. It's kind of moderate damage, but I think he should be okay. Nathan Stapleton was involved. Derek Campbell, the number 15, with a little bit of damage on his race car. Is there any damage on the points leader? That's what I want to know. I believe there might be damage on the points leader. I'm not 100% certain on that, though. Don't quote me on that. Let's see if there's any damage. And there is damage on our points leader, Emmanuel Hartnett. Heavy right side damage to his N29 Pontiac. That's big. That is really huge. Because, I mean, Emmanuel Hartnett should still be okay to continue. However, the problem is, if he has just the smallest ounce of damage, his aerodynamics are going to be not as good, not up to par with everybody else. That is that has a clean race car. So that means we could definitely see the points shake up once again. And if I'm correct, the only other driver that is still running up front, well, really close to the front, that has no damage, is the number 85 of Zachary Taylor. So if he were to just finish the race, well, just finish ahead, obviously ahead of Emmanuel Hartnett, he could take the points lead. But however, you can't count out Allison Rain. Allison Rain right now is third of the point standings with 124 points in the bank. So not too far from behind from Zachary Taylor. So if she finishes ahead of Zachary Taylor, she takes the points lead, heading over to Charlotte next week. But nonetheless, though, the plot thickens when it comes down to the point standings, even though we are on our fifth race of the season. But let's go back and take a look and see what happened that caused our first caution of the day here at the Talladega Super Speedway. Ray Atikian is your race leader. So what really transpired here was a little bit of four wide. See the number 82 Bronson Mink down on the inside. It looks like Hamill was trying to give a little bit of room to him. Slides up in front of William Brock, and who then both go up into the number 97 of Stapleton, and as well as the 20 of Emmanuel Hartnett. That's where he got his damage into the outside wall. And so far, it was only just a four-car jam session. Here comes Quentin Moore. Barely anywhere to go. He collects also just barely the 79 of Tanner Parton. And if you have any sort of epilepsy, I recommend you look away and just listen because of the smoke that's just constantly just flashing up a storm. I do apologize for that. But you see Zachary Fitzwater, who got the heaviest amount of damage in this incident in turns number 3 and 4. Fitzy has pulled his car back behind the wall. Unfortunately, he is done for the day. Quentin Moore, Derek Hamill, I believe William Brogdon, as well as Nathan Stapleton, are all going to continue. Obviously, Emmanuel Hartnett has taken his car back out onto the racetrack, so he is for sure going to keep going in this race. But as far as Zachary Fitzwater, unfortunately, game over for the number 98 here today at Talladega. Riding with Fitzy, he actually had a little buckle on his hood previously. Not sure how he got it, but there's the wreck. Man, I'm not sure why he committed to the line that he committed to, but Quentin Moore was right there. But had he made a decision to check up a little bit and see if he could drive high, if he could go around him on the high side, then maybe Fitzy would have still been in this thing. But unfortunately, he drove right into the back end of the zero of Quentin Moore. And then vice versa. That is unfortunately what's going to end his day. And ultimately, he's going to take a big hit in the point standings for sure. Because he came into this event just outside of the top 10, 12th in the standings with 100 points in the bank, and definitely not something that definitely not the result that Fitzy was looking for. And this is definitely not something that Fitzy wants, especially going over to Charlotte. Maybe he could try to do better over there in the Coca-Cola 600 next Sunday. But it's definitely going to be very interesting to see if Fitzy is going to be able to climb out of this hole, and how quickly he can do it. But anyways, the number 69 of Ray Atikian currently is your race leader. We're closing in on the halfway point here in the Aaron's 499, so let's go ahead and get to the restart here at Talladega. One lap, and we will be back to green flag racing here at the Talladega Super Speedway. We are closing in on the halfway point. Ray Atikian is your race leader. The running in second is the one of Wayne Lopez. Third is Audra Baranowskis. Fourth is Mitchell Collins. Fifth is Haley Couris. 6th is the number 22 of Alex Bonsuer. 7th is Joshua Hyatt. 8th is Henry Williams for the first time showing up inside of the top 10. 9th is Emily Anderson, and Bradley Bradshaw completes the top 10. The first Hamill Racing Enterprises car since Bob Floyd to crack the top 10. See, the drivers only out of the race are the two drivers. I was wrong about William Brock. Brock has taken his car back behind the wall. He alongside Zachary Fitzwater have both smelled what the Rock was cooking. So we only have 40 cars left on the racetrack. Surprisingly enough, it was only just a 5-6 car pileup. Well, 5-6 car melee here in turns 3 and 4. But we should be good to go here. Maybe the rest of the way. I'm not 100% sure if we're going to be able to go green the rest of the way, but we're about to find out. As the field comes off of turn number 4, pace car will head down pit road this time. And the field is put back into the hands of race leader Ray Etikian for EGI. And then, of course, Wayne Lopez, Baranauskas, Collins, Kuras completing the top 5. Back through the restart zone. There's the green flag. We're back underway. 20 laps to go, and we're on the halfway point. All in the process. Couple other drivers way in the back just jumped out of line, one of those being Bradley Bradshaw. Unfortunately, he's going to pay the price for that. Wyatt Walker's going to get down to the inside. Wayne Lopez, meanwhile, up front has ducked low. Audra Baranauskas went even lower. 3 wide once again as they go back into turn number 3. This is all for the race lead. And Etikian is going to be the biggest loser in that fight. He's going to drop back with absolutely no help whatsoever. They are 3 wide already at the front of the field. They've already settled it back down to double file as quickly as they went 3 wide. Baranauskas takes the lead back, leads that lap. And they're 3 wide once again. This time Mitchell Collins being the recipient of being put up into the third line. On the back straightaway once again. Everybody now starting to fan right back out and start racing exactly how they did before the caution came out. Kuras, who was denied from her first win back at Rockingham, trying to go for it once again. She goes low for the top position and going to try to lead this lap, even though it's not going to count towards the championship or anything, because remember, she has red stripes on her car, so she is essentially, she's pretty much just one of the part-time drivers competing in this event. One of 6. Henry Williams now put 4 wide. It's Colin Cropley, the 75 down low. There's Michael DeFeo showing back up into the mix. Ryan Gundillo in the 51, who is also making his first start. You see Baranauskas looking low for the race lead. And Walker's going to drop low. He's going to go with Baranauskas. Bradshaw's going to go with Walker. So that's 3 cars lined up on the bottom. And that leaves Kuras hung out to dry, at least for the moment. Here comes Walker back down to the inside. This time it's for the race lead. But not going to be able to get the job done. Baranauskas had a good enough run to where she could just hang on and lead that lap. Now Gundillo being forced into the middle line by the 25, Stephen Colon. As they head down the back straightaway once again, Walker's going to take the race lead as they go down the back stretch. Bradley Bradshaw, Stephen Colon, we're going to make it 3 wide. Bob Floyd, a pair of HRE teammates in the middle lane, 47 and 11. But so far, not a whole lot of progress being made in just trying to maintain their positions as far as trying to stay up on that second line. But the 25 of Cologne leads that lap back into turn number 1. Wrong end of the racetrack. Oh man, oh man, things are starting to get very, very interesting, at least in this battle for the top position. See Zachary Taylor, that number 85, ducking low. 4 cars. Now 5 lined up on the inside line. 6. They all start to fan out. They were almost 4 wide. They are 4 wide. Halt. And that 17 is going to lose a lot of ground. He went from third. Let's see. He went from third to 10th. Third to 10th in just one lap. Not as bad as what Bob Floyd experienced earlier in the race when he went from 8th to 25th in one lap. But so far, Zachary Taylor still holds on to the lead. He led the last lap. Why Walker wants to lead another one. He goes low. Michael DeFay on that number 6 is going to follow close behind in that number 6 machine. Cropley was peeking the nose out a little bit going through 3 and 4. And now they're 3 wide once again. Walker's going to hang on. He'll lead this lap. Man, I am kind of having a little bit of a tough time right now, not just with commentary, but also just trying to keep up with everybody. But anyways, Walker retains the race lead as far as when he took it back in turn number 3, the last lap around. Colin Cropley in the 75 is going to lose the second position to Michael DeFeo. And look at who has also come up into the mix. Gekko Holt in the 27. Holt now trapped in the second line, but still hanging on inside of the top 10. I'm not sure for how much longer, though. Andrew Miller now stuck in the middle in the 80 machine. He's going to be 3 wide with Jack Lagasse and Stephen Colon for another couple more seconds before getting put back into the second lane. And now here comes Michael DeFeo down to the inside with help from Alex Bonsignor. How about that? A couple of racing buddies that love the Modified Tour. Ironically enough, they both love the Modified Tour. So now they're working together. DeFeo goes to the point. Bonsignor looking to just edge ahead of Walker for second. And Taylor is going to tag along right behind him until they come off of turn number 4. But look at this. Double file. I thought they were going to go 3 wide for a second. But Cologne immediately shoots to the inside to try to take that third position away. They're 3 wide as Bonsignor guns for the lead on Michael DeFeo as they come off of turn number 2. He's going to take it. Now can he get clear up? Can he get up on the outside? No, he can't. Well, he can theoretically from that angle. But now he is 100% clear of Michael DeFeo, but he may not be clear from this whole inside line that just powered their way right up to the back end of Alex Bonsignor. They're 3 wide once again. There's Michael Ramsey now trapped in the middle, that number 42. And Jack Lagasse is going to take the lead. 11 laps to go here at Talladega. They're 3 wide once again. Wayne Lopez now down to the inside. Travis Crampton in the middle. Gordon is now back into the mix in the 77. He, remember, as I said at the beginning of the race, he needs a good run. He needs great runs like these, spectacular runs, if he wants to move out of dead last in the points. He's going to take third position away from the number 61 of Crampton. But at least Crampton is not on the third or even fourth line. I spoke a little too soon. He just went up there. And now he's going to start losing a lot of ground. 10 laps to go here at Talladega. And they're catching up to the slower traffic of Quinton Moore, who has already entered turn number 2. Dogfight for the race lead between a pair of Fords, Lopez and Lagasse, running it back from Michigan. Kicked off the season back in April. Now they've caught up to Quinton Moore a lot faster than when I thought they would. Quinton Moore's going to block the bottom, and that's going to... Oh, my goodness. He blocked everybody. I don't know how he did it, but Quinton Moore managed to block everybody, and now everybody is starting to stack up. 4, 5 wide. They are 5 wide coming through the tri-oval. This is all just trying to get around Quinton Moore. They're still 5 wide. Oh, no. Oh, man. Oh, no. There they go. The EGI car's involved. There's Henry Williams. Michael Ramsey collected. Oh no, Tanner Parton, Nathan Stapleton. Just pile right in. Oh my goodness. The caution is out. They're racing it back to the flag. Andrew Miller has the lead as they come off of turn number four. Ryan Gundillo trying to take it as they come through the trioval and to the caution flag. It will be the number, let's see, at the stripe. Andrew Miller will be leading them back to the caution flag. That is such a shame. Such a shame with what we just witnessed there in turn number two. But that's just a byproduct of trying to avoid slower traffic. Henry Williams majorly destroyed. Our Mosport winner heavily torn up. Nathan Stapleton in the 97 was having himself a really good run all the way up until the very bitter end. Emily Anderson, another driver who's going to take a hit in the point standings. Elijah Gordon, who needed a great run in this event to move himself out of dead last in the points. Unfortunately, he's not going to get the result that he was looking for. Michael Ramsey, who was having himself a great run, tried to stay out of trouble all the way up until lap 30. Audra Baranowska's small buckle on the hood of her race car, but she should be okay to continue on. Ray Atikian with a lot of rear-end damage to his machine. And there's Quentin Moore, who was involved in the first incident. Unfortunately, is the center of attention in the second incident. This is very, very ironic of how Quentin Moore is driving a zero. He's in a Ford. And he was involved in two incidents at Talladega. This reminds me of the Arcom Pepsi Amateur Series race here at Talladega just 2 years ago when he was the center of attention. When he caused two incidents. Both yellow flags that saw two major crashes through turns three and four. This time it happens in turn number two, but I find it ironic, but he didn't necessarily cause the caution. This was just caused by everybody trying to avoid Quentin Moore, who was considerably slower than everybody else. But nonetheless, Andrew Miller is your race leader. Closing in on five laps to go. This is going to be very interesting to see how this race will end. So let's go back and take a look and see what happened that caused our second yellow flag of the day here and the Aaron's 499 right here at Talladega. We had some really good racing all the way up until this point. Within 10 laps to go, you see Mitchell Collins move up into Gekka Hall, who then gets forced up into Anderson, then to Gordon, and then it is on from there. Not much to really explain. You see three of the EGI cars collected in this one. Not a good day for EGI whatsoever. John Andrews in the 28. Trinity River Racing. Well, two of their cars theoretically involved in this. A Trinity River Racing car technically started the incident. The other one just barely made it through. But you see here comes Tanner Parton and Nathan Stapleton, who both pile drive. The number 66 car of Emily Anderson, more so Tanner Parton than Nathan Stapleton. Stapleton had no idea what was going on because he had a windshield full of the rowdy energy machine of Parton, who he was glued to the rear end of. But, man, that is just so unfortunate. We had a lot of good race cars that could have either won or gotten a really good finish. And unfortunately are not going to see the checkered flag here at the Talladega Super Speedway. They'll theoretically see it. Well, they'll pretty much see the checkered flag. They just won't be crossing the start-finish line when that checkered flag falls. So this is at speed. This is looking from the skybox at the center of the trioval. As they head back into turn number one, look at this. It's just a very... You can go five wide, but you run the risk of this happening. You run, because one small move will cause an incident like this, especially for drivers that are just trying to avoid the accident, kind of like what Tanner Parton and Nathan Stapleton were trying to do. But I believe ARCA brakes might have just pretty much ended their days a little bit earlier than what they were expecting. So we're going to go on board with Nathan Stapleton and take a look and see what kind of mess he had to see, especially when he was just hanging around in the back drafting with Tanner Parton. The incident happens. He sees it. But from this, from the visor point of view, he's got a whole windshield full of Tanner Parton. He couldn't really see what was going on ahead of him. So he was just following Parton. He had as much trust as he could possibly put in to Tanner Parton. But unfortunately, it led to both of them just getting a lot of major damage from Tanner Parton really hitting Emily Anderson in the rear end, and Nathan Stapleton just having absolutely no idea of what was going on ahead of him because of Tanner Parton being in his windshield, just pile driving the back end of the 79 machine. And that's what's going to end both of their days, unfortunately. But we are within inside of 10 laps to go. I believe we're within 5 to go here at the Talladega Super Speedway. Andrew Miller is your race leader. Let's go back and head to the restart to see what the finish will look like here at Talladega. One lap and we will be back to green flag racing at the Talladega Super Speedway. And we have more retirees coming into this one. Of course, Elijah Gordon, there's Quentin Moore, Emily Anderson, Henry Williams, Tanner Parton, and Nathan Stapleton have joined William Brock and Zachary Fitzwater in the booth, or in the garage area, not in the booth. We'd be crammed in here. But they have smelled what the Rock was cooking. Unfortunately, within 10 laps to go, here they come through to the restart zone as pace car drops off. They'll be restarting with 4 laps to go. It's Miller, Gondillo, Perez, Hyatt, Bonsinger, the top 5, then Austin, Lagasse, Collins, Walker, and Clifton, who for the first time has shown up inside of the top 10. They'll be restarting with 4 laps to go. Green flag in the air. Bonsinger wasting no time. He goes to the outside line, but he's going to pay the price for that. Nobody really went with him, but he might get picked up by Mitchell Collins here in just a little bit as they come off of turn number 2, heading down the back straightaway, just trying to get up to speed. Brayton Perez looks low. Looks like the 3 of Joshua Hyatt may go with him, or will he? They're going to go 3 wide, maybe not. No, Ryan Gondillo is going to be the lone driver to the inside of Andrew Miller for the top position as they come through turns 3 and 4. Gondillo making his first start on the season. Going to try to go for his first win of the year and of his career. They're coming to 3 to go this time by Joshua Hyatt in the second position. How about Wyatt Walker, who went from 9th now to 4th in just 1 lap. Now to 3rd as he tries to get by Andrew Miller. 4 wide as Brayton Perez gets shuffled way out of line. They come down the back straightaway once again. Gondillo still holding on to it. The duo of Bass Pro Shop cars, nose to tail. Are they going to work together? Yes, they will. Down to the inside they go on Ryan Gondillo. And Hyatt and Walker are going to take 1st and 2nd away from the 51 machine. But look at this. The two NS Racing cars are working together. Miller and Clifton get to the inside of Wyatt Walker. They come to 2 to go. Clifton is going to go 3 wide. But he didn't get the move done heading into turn number 1. Miller slams the door in front of Clifton as they come off of turn number 2. Hyatt still holding on to the top position as they come down the back straightaway. Lap and a half to go. They'll be faced with the white flag. And no matter what happens, if the caution comes out, we're going to race it back no matter what. A trio of Chevrolets lead the field as they come off of turn number 4. They'll be heading to the tri-oval once again. Miller and Clifton to the inside. No, they won't. 3 wide. They are 3 wide for the race lead. Trouble in the back. The caution is out. They come to the start-finish line. It is over in Talladega. Joshua Hyatt is going to win the Aaron's 499 here at Talladega. Wow. Oh my goodness, what a finish. What a way to end it here at Talladega Super Speedway. Third and final yellow. Michael DeFeo, who is having himself a great run. Unfortunately, this is going to end pretty not so well for him. Allison Rain, who is third in the point standings. She's going to take a big hit. And I believe those are the only few drivers I've seen collected. Actually, other than Jack Lagasse. Lagasse was involved in that final crash that brought out the final yellow flag. Man, oh man, we saw a really great fight for the finish. We saw a great fight for the win all the way to the very bitter end. Now how about this? How fitting. The number three, who is very synonymous with all the success in the real life racing, cup racing here at Talladega, comes around through turn four into the trioval for one last time. Joshua Hyatt for Full Frontal Motorsports is going to take the checkered flag and nab his first career victory here at Talladega. He wins the Aaron's 499. First Pepsi Cup Series win, I believe, for Full Frontal Motorsports. First career win for Joshua Hyatt, and he gets it done at Talladega. How about that? That is unbelievable of what we just witnessed. Of course, Andrew Miller, who also came close to his first win. He's going to come home in the second position. Noah Clifton, who came close to getting his first win on the year, second of his career, comes home third, of course. And then you have CG Hall fourth. Wayne Lopez completed the top five. Then Gekka Holt, who almost went for her second win on the season, coming home in the sixth position. Al Lagasse seventh. Reagan Whitlock coming home in the eighth spot. Ryan Gandolo in his first race back in the Cup Series comes home ninth. And Wyatt Walker rounds out the top 10. As these drivers head back to pit road and as Joshua Hyatt prepares for his trip to victory lane, let's go ahead and review the crash that brought out our final caution flag here at the Talladega Super Speedway that ultimately put the win in Joshua Hyatt's lap. So this was coming off of turn number four, coming to the white flag. You see right here, Michael DeFeo, as they head into the trioval, watch DeFeo in the number six. It's a combination of things. It looks like Allison Rain might have come up a little bit just to try to avoid staying off the double yellow line. But you also saw DeFeo come down as if he was clear to try to tuck in behind Allison Rain. And you saw it there. Rain, DeFeo, Collins all shot up in the Jag lag scene. All four of them went up hard into the outside wall, right here in the trioval. And this was the incident that ended the race and gave Joshua Hyatt his first career win on the year. This is the second race that this has happened. If you remember, all the way back in the season opener at Michigan, race ended in a very similar fashion. Only difference was it ended in a photo finish with Zachary Taylor and Quentin Moore, with Taylor being the victor in that deal. One more time at speed, this time from the skybox. There's just a lot happening there. Well, not a whole lot, but there was just really very, very little time to react for all these other drivers DeFeo and Rain, because they both came up and came down on each other at the same time. And that's what forced all of them up into the outside wall, as well as Collins. Collins was just an innocent bystander to that whole ordeal. And unfortunately, he's going to end the race with damage and not the best of finishes. But nonetheless, still a great valiant effort for Mitchell Collins nonetheless. But let's go ahead and now review your finishing results from 11th through 42nd with Joshua Hyatt, the victor. So as you see your finishing results from 11th through 42nd, what an amazing turn of events here at the Talladega Super Speedway. Great racing all around. I mean, very, very interesting pack racing all at the same time. But it was that older style of super speedway plate racing, especially when the drivers are not really all as grouped up as we would usually see in the modern day. But nonetheless, at the end of the day, it provided some really good action nonetheless. Three caution flags, and the third and final caution, ultimately giving Joshua Hyatt his first career victory on the season. Not just on the season, but also his career. First win also as well, if I'm not mistaken, for Full Frontal Motorsports. Do apologize for that little botch there. For the WRLA Pepsi Cup Series. And that will pretty much do it from here at the Talladega Super Speedway. A couple drivers that unfortunately are still going to take some pretty big hits. Of course, Emmanuel Hartnett, he most likely will lose the points lead to Zachary Taylor. Allison Rain, another driver that... hold on a second. There's a good chance that Andrew Miller may be the points leader, because remember, he finished second in this race. He finished second. So he is the highest finisher out of anybody inside of the top five. So who knows? So most likely, there's a very, very high chance that Andrew Miller will be the points leader heading into Charlotte Motor Speedway next Sunday, the Coca-Cola 600. That all goes down, and I believe the graphic will tell you, but I believe the time will be at 5 p.m. Eastern time. I'm excited, man. I'm excited. Coca-Cola 600. This is my favorite time of year. Especially in Memorial Day weekend, Indianapolis 500, Monaco Grand Prix, Coca-Cola 600, all in one day. This is going to be one hell of a weekend, and I am looking forward to it, especially for the NR side. We've got the Indiana Bash coming up, the Indianapolis 100, the Freedom 50, the Indianapolis 250, the Coca-Cola 600 for the Pepsi Cup Series, for crying out loud. So, you know, this is going to be one wild weekend, full of excitement, full of racing, and we're looking forward for you guys to keep up to date with everything that's going on throughout the course of this upcoming week. Thank you so much for watching. Here are your point standings one more time. Congratulations to Joshua Hyatt on nabbing his first career victory, and that's pretty much going to do it, guys. We'll see you next week at Charlotte, but if we just see you beforehand, we'll see you at Indianapolis for the Indiana Bash and the Indianapolis 100. Take care, guys. Have a great rest of your day.